Our next topic is the rock cycle. The rock cycle is a model that shows how all three of the rock types formed and how they are all related to one another. Here's the model of the rock cycle shown in your textbook. It's not really my favorite, actually. To me, it makes it look like extrusive rocks come from intrusive rocks, which is really not the case. I prefer this model here. It's similar, but I think it's more instructive. We're actually going to draw a model of the rock cycle, so get out a piece of paper, and I'd like to have you draw this, and I'll walk you through it. We're going to develop a pool and process model of the rock cycle. So I encourage you to draw it for yourself on a piece of paper as I'm drawing it here. So first, we remember that the boxes represent the pools where the material hangs out. So this first box we're going to call magma. Next, arrows represent the processes that move material from one pool to another. So what pool, what would this be here? What rock type is formed from magma? Hopefully you said igneous rocks. And then remember also, we need to label the process. So let's label the arrow. This process is cooling and crystallization. Next, we can draw another arrow here from igneous rocks to another pool. Now, if we think about all those igneous rocks in the Sierras, like the granite of the Sierras, and then consider what happens to that over time, it basically weathers away to sediment. So we can label our next box sediment, and we'll call this process, which we're going to talk about in more detail in a few weeks, weathering. It's basically the breaking apart of rock into small pieces. From there, let's think about what rock is made from sediment. Which rock type is made from sediment? Hopefully you said sedimentary rocks. And then we need to label the arrow, the process, and that process is lithification. Or you could write cementation and compaction. And what can happen to those rocks? What other rock can they form? Well, we only have one rock type left. That's our metamorphic rocks. And indeed, they are made from pre-existing rocks. So our metamorphic rocks, forming by the process of metamorphism, which is high temperatures and pressures. And then lastly, to finish our cycle here, what can happen to a metamorphic rock to create magma? That'd be melting. So there we have it. We've made a pool and process model of the rock cycle. And again, I encourage you to do that for yourself in your notes. I love the rock cycle. It shows so many things. It shows that you know how each of the rock types is formed. Igneous rocks forms by the cooling and crystallization of magma. Sedimentary rocks are formed by the lithification of sediment. And metamorphic rocks are formed by metamorphism of other rocks. Now, clearly, this is only a simplification, right? All models are simplifications. Because we know, for instance, that igneous rocks could melt and become magma. Igneous rocks could undergo high temperatures and pressures and become metamorphic rocks. Sedimentary rocks could melt and become magma, or they could get broken down into sediment. And metamorphic rocks could get broken down into sediment. Right? And metamorphic rocks could even turn into other metamorphic rocks. So there's all sorts of other arrows that could be drawn in here. But this is just one simple way to draw the whole cycle. You'll notice there's the three rock types and then two other intermediaries. So ultimately, there's five pools and five processes that connect them. I encourage you to practice drawing the pool and process model of the rock cycle several times, just so they get a real handle on how all these rock types are related and how each of the three rock types forms. Looking back at the diagram that I provided, you can see it's pretty much what we drew. You have a pool for magma. It can cool and crystallize to form igneous rock, both intrusive and extrusive, which can weather to form sediment, which can undergo lithification, cementation, and compaction to form sedimentary rock, which can undergo metamorphism, high heat and high temperature and pressure, to form a metamorphic rock, which can be melted again to form magma. Five pools and five processes. The rock cycle.